Come away and rest. He looked on them with compassion. Jesus had sent the disciples out after he had been rejected by his hometown, where nobody believed that he could be the Holy One of God. He gathered the 12 together and sent them out to heal. He sent them out to free people. And then they come back to share the stories, to tell about what they had done. And they were so busy talking that none of them had time to eat. And Jesus saw that they were so tired and weary. So he said, come away with me and rest. And so they got into that boat and sailed a little farther down the lake, away from the crowds that had been around Jesus. But the crowds saw him in the boat and followed along to where they were landing, gathering there on the seashore. And Jesus looked out of the boat and saw all those people there waiting for him. And he had compassion on them. And he invited the disciples, give them something to eat. And the disciples looked out at the crowd of men, women, and children and said, how can we afford them? How can we pay for all of them to eat? And Jesus looked at them. Give them something to eat. And he invited them to share what they had. And they came up with 5 loaves of bread and 2 fishes. And he took those 5 loaves and 2 fishes and blessed it and broke it and gave it. He looked out at the crowd and saw that they were weary. Said, come away and rest. He looked with compassion. That man knocked on the door to my office, that office door that nobody went to. I think everybody thought it was a fire exit. Knocked on the door and asked for money for milk and for money for his daughter's favorite cereal. And I invited him to go downstairs because it was food pantry day and it was totally available for him if he went downstairs. And he told me that his daughter doesn't like that, as his daughter is standing there. And I know in my heart that he works the system all the time and his daughter is standing there looking at me. And so what do? I give, because Jesus says, you give them something to. Come away with me, you're weary. Come away and rest. They looked at them with compassion. So we are so excited. We're downtown Chicago to see Hamilton outside, waiting for the doors to open. And a man comes up and asks for money. And I always, when I go downtown, have $2 or $3 that are just meant to give to the homeless who ask me for money. So I pull out my money, hand it to him, and then he goes and talks to the next person in line. That man must have raked in hundreds of dollars that night. So my heart was feeling a little not compassionate, but I remembered in my brain and my interior that Jesus said give. He didn't say ask what they were going to do with it. He said, come away with me. Come and rest. And he looked at them with compassion. In Eritrea right now, starving from a man-made famine. People are literally starving to death because their political opponents will not let any food or anything into their region. People are literally starving to death because of a political disagreement. A man-made disaster is killing people every day. Jesus looked and said, "Give them something to eat." In Madagascar, they have not had rain in the southern section for 2 years. They've had a couple of storms that have blown through, but if you know when storms come through in a place that has been in a drought, it means the water all just runs right off the land because it doesn't have time to sink in, because it comes in so fast and so hard that it doesn't stay. And so they could count 3 storms that they've had in 2 years in southern Madagascar. Last year they were feeding 100,000 people. This February they had 300,000. By June they had 900,000. Now they are at 1.31 million people affected by famine. And this famine is also man-made, because it's caused by climate change changing the weather patterns that grows over the island of Madagascar. And so when the people who are so trying to fix the problem in Madagascar see such a huge problem to fix, because how do you change weather patterns? How do you get water to a place where there is no water? How do you, as a person who is starving to death, walk to the northern part of the island when it is so far away? Even 10 miles, if you haven't had anything to eat, is farther than you can do. The people in Madagascar are so hungry that in order to satisfy their children so their children can sleep at night, they take tamarind juice and mix it with white clay and the leaves of cactuses and feed that to their children at night. How do you change a place that is dry? How do you save a million people who are starving? I wish I had a good answer for you, because what you have to do is change everything. And this is a culture of small pot farmers, meaning that they grow enough to feed themselves and to sell that little bit of extra for the things that they can't make themselves. And they've lost all that. All that land is now sand, creating sandstorms blowing through. How do you bring it back to life? Because you need trees that can survive in low water in order to put moisture back into the soil. But trees take money. You need to grow crops that will survive in a desert environment. Their main crop was rice. How does rice grow? It can't grow in a desert environment. So you not only have to change what you grow, you have to change how you grow it. In fact, there was a picture that I saw when I was looking on the World Food Program website about Madagascar that showed a man who goes to the ocean in order to get water to bring it back to the village using oxen. Can you imagine that the only water you have is the ocean surrounding you? And it's salt water. But that's it. That's the water you have. You give them something to eat. Jesus said, "Come away with me and rest." Looked at them with compassion. Those firefighters are so tired and exhausted. When they have a break and are sent back to rest, there are people there that have created meals for them, and they eat barely awake and then sleep in order to go back and fight the fires. of self-pity. Jesus looked out and saw that they were weary. He looked out with compassion and said, come and rest. He looked at Louisiana and saw that they're still without power. But he sent Chef Andre there. And Chef Andre has been making meals because he had the generators available to feed the people in the areas where he went. He also set up feeding posts when the rains poured down into New York and people were in trouble because of the massive rains that landed. He also sent a kitchen to Haiti where the people were hungry. Chef Andre heard those words loud and clear. You give them something to eat. He looked out and saw that everyone was weary, bone tired and hungry. And he said, come away and rest. He looked at them with compassion. Jesus is looking at us with eyes of compassion. And sometimes he's looking at us and saying, you're so weary. Let me break the bread and hand it to you. And sometimes he's looking at you and saying, you give them something to eat. Because Jesus knows where we need to be to help the dawning kingdom be born. He knows that sometimes we are the ones who are weary and lost and hungry. Sometimes we are the ones who are in need of rest. Sometimes we are the ones who need compassion. And then other days when he looks at us, when he looks deep at us, he knows that we are the ones who can feed others. We are the ones who have the strength and the courage to spread the dawning kingdom, to give someone something.